Hi, everybody. Wow, you are a good-looking bunch of people. You really are. I think you should give yourselves a round of applause. My name is Melanie Thomas. I'm with the Voluntary and Nonprofit Secretariat with the Government of Newfoundland and Labrador. We have a couple of housekeeping items we wanted to run through with you this evening before we kick off the show. First and foremost, if everybody could take a moment and turn off their cell phones or put them on vibrate, that would be great. If you need to go to the washrooms, that is, they're just over here to the left, fully accessible. Also, so you know, St. John Ambulance are present here this evening, should you need them, and they're located at the back of the room. And in the event of a fire, although the only hot thing here tonight is going to be the rockin' show we have in store for you. Fire exits are located to my left, at the entrance you came in, and at the back of the room to the right. I want to send a huge thanks to our host this evening, Jonny Harris. Jonny, in fact, rearranged his schedule at the Halifax Comedy Festival so he could be here with us tonight. Without further ado, your host for the evening, Jonny Harris.
Thanks very much. I'll take it. Any opportunity to come home, I'll take it. I've been up in Toronto for the last couple of years, so I really love it when I get to come home. You know, people give Toronto a hard time, right? They say it's unfriendly, but the thing is, Toronto, it gets a bad rap. You just got to realize in a city that size, you're going to encounter cultural differences, right? Like that many different ethnicities, peoples of all shapes and colors, you're going to run in. People just do things a little different there, right? Like even just in the way that you would greet somebody. Like here in Newfoundland and Labrador, we often give someone like a nod and a wink, right? Like you just greet someone like that, right? In St. John's, often we'll cock it off to the side too, right? Just give it over there a little bit. And just in Toronto, it's just a little bit different. It's a bit more like... Right? Little cultural differences in Toronto. Like, I always find it funny how in Toronto, people would order pizza by the whole and eat it sober. Although they got snarky bums in Toronto, and I'll never get used to that, right? I remember I came out of the Eaton Center one time, and there was a guy there, and he asked me for some change, and I had some in my hand, so I gave it to him. He starts picking out pennies and nickels and throwing them away. Anything smaller than a dime got tossed, right? And I was giving him a bit of a look. And he looks at me, he goes, "What? You think you're better than me?" I said, "I think I'm doing better than you." But the reason I've been up in Toronto is I've been working on a TV show up there called The Murdoch Mysteries, right? And it's got a core cast of only four people. The main guy, the detective, is played by a fella from Ontario. Right, the doctor in the show is played by a woman from Australia. The police chief is played by a fellow from England who is actually on Coronation Street. He's our star power, right? And then the goofy constable, the comic relief, is played by a Newfoundlander. So we all make fun of each other's accents a little bit, right? All in good spirit, but the thing is, none of them can really do a Newfoundland accent. In fact, I think that nobody who's ever... if they are not from Newfoundland, has ever really successfully done a Newfoundland accent. Like look at Judi Dench, Dame Judi Dench, right? Brilliant actress, shipping news, couldn't really pull off the Newfoundland accent, right? So I've written a little thing here, maybe a warning of sorts to actors who think they can attempt to put one on. To get it right would be an infinite learning process. And before undertaking such a task, one should ask themselves if they can really commit to it. Sure, you may be able to turn the odd TH sound into a D, but anyone can do that. You might even spot your dialogue with the odd by. Even the most ambitious might learn to drop or add a H here or there. But even then, there is still a long journey ahead. And to go that road, you must be pure of heart. You must learn to add and drop letters you cannot even imagine. Ask yourself, are you willing to take the B out of bumblebee? Do you know that there is a T on the edge of every clift? Are you ready to sacrifice an S for the spirit of Christmas? Did you know that your uncle's son is your cousin? And have you been leaving the L out of chimney? In short, do you have the dedication of someone who would heat a apple heaven if they ate it heating apples? All right, so let's get down to business here. We are here for the URock Volunteer Awards. It's a night to celebrate the many accomplishments and contributions that young volunteers have made to Newfoundland and Labrador, okay? We're here to say you rock. Let me hear you say you rock.
You rock.
When I say you say rock. You?
Rock.
You?
Rock.
When I say we, you say rock. We?
Rock.
We?
Rock.
When I say Rocky, you say five. Rocky?
Five.
Rocky, five. When I say, can you smell, you say, what the rocket's cooking. Can you smell? Audience call and response abilities. Low. To very low. All right. Now, we've got a new note here that was just added to the script. We just want you to know how much, to show you how much you rock, tonight's red carpet, the one that you just walked on, is the same red carpet that last week graced Drake, Kanan, Michael Bublé, Metric, and Justin Bieber? Is this true? Justin Bieber was on this carpet? I can smell him. Oh my God, I got the Bieber fever. Sorry, that was very undignified. I should not have done that. You know, they had to whisk Michael Bublé away right away after the Junos because they were afraid that the volcanic ash cloud was going to come in, right? And they also had to whisk Justin Bieber away right away because he was late for Cubs. And he didn't have his Cub car made for the Cub car rally. All right, now I've got myself all turned around here. Okay.